one of the nice things about our liturgical life in the church is that you're allowed to celebrate saints' days for 8 days after those days have come, which is kind of a nice thing. It's called an octave. So if you have somebody that you're, some saint you're particularly fond of remembering, it's okay to remember them for 8 days. It's okay to meditate on what they mean for those 8 days. And that's particularly important when you come to a big Saints' Day like All Saints' Day. All Saints' Day fell last Thursday. We call this All Saints' Sunday. But we're in the octave of All Saints, which means that you have these 8 days to think about saints, to think about what it means to be a saint, what it means to be holy, because that's really what it's about. It's about holy people. And of course, in the life of the church, we have these really big saints, these people who have been voted in by one person or one conclave or another, voted in because in their lives they have called the church to its better self. They have raised up a vision in the way they lived of what the church is supposed to be. And the church has acknowledged that after the fact and said, wow, that person called us higher, called us into the true calling of discipleship, into the calling of being the church. So we will call them and remember them by the name saint, by the name holy, because we recognize in them a certain holiness. Well, you and I, we have our own saints. You have all those, we all have those people who in our own lives have done exactly the same thing those saints have done for the church, which is to call us higher, to call us to live into the fullness of who we're really meant to be, call us to our better selves, to inspire us and lift us and teach us in a way of how to live. And we give thanks during the All Saints octave for those saints as well. Some are still alive and we live with them. Some of them aren't alive anymore and we give thanks for them. There's a kind of nostalgia that goes with All Saints Day because so often so many of our saints for our own lives have died. And so when we remember that sort of litany of those who've died, there's a melancholy that goes with their passing still. And it's a melancholy, it's not just a sense of loss about them. It's a melancholy about ourselves, that we haven't lived into what they had hoped for us. We didn't live into the fullness of what we could be because we know ourselves and we know that we haven't lived into the fullness of holiness and goodness and all that we are intended to be. So in this season of this octave of All Saints, we think a little bit about what it means to be holy. What is a saint? What is the communion of saints? I've been thinking about this for the last few days because we've been in the, you've already missed 3 or 4 days. Because we've been in this octave for a few days now. And I was struck yesterday. Yesterday I went to the diocesan convention, as did my sister Mercedes, and some other nice people. I'm not fond of diocesan convention. You know, it's the way conventions are, and you got to do business, and there's a lot of talk about money, and there are a lot of people you don't know, and there are a lot of different people with different agendas, and it's hard to cozy up to people in a convention setting. And so I usually arrive grumpy, and I usually leave grumpy. But I look forward in some senses, because there are some people I know I'm going to see who I do love, like Ann Burke. That's the high point of the convention, is that I get to see Ann Burke. But yesterday was a sort of typical convention. You know, and the problem is the problem is they're people, and there's temptations to pridefulness, and everybody's pleased with their own parishes and what they're doing, and not listening so much to everybody else. So there's a lot of occasions for sin in a convention. And we spent the morning talking about church budgets and the diocesan budget. That was okay. It was a great presentation. It was fine. But it doesn't lift your spirits. But then, after lunch, we talked about this resolution that had been put forward about immigration and refugees.